Welcome to Merit Studio. I am Dr. Rajarajan. Simple Pendulum, a simple device that has large significance in learning physics. It is just a mass hung by a string. Now let us see what happens when I pull this mass to one side and leave it. It starts moving to and fro. This is called an oscillatory motion. The center point of oscillation is called equilibrium position. That is where it was when we started the motion. The distance it travels onto one side from the equilibrium point is called the amplitude of oscillation. The time taken for one full oscillation is called the time period. Let us measure the length of the pendulum. It is 15 centimeter. Now let us measure the time period. For this, we will make the pendulum oscillate and let it make a few oscillations. Then we will start the clock when pendulum comes to one end. Start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. This is time taken for 20 oscillations, from which we can calculate time for one oscillation. The time taken for 20 oscillations is 15.73 seconds, which shows the time taken for one oscillation is roughly 0.75 seconds. Now we will repeat this measurement for a different length of the pendulum. The length of the pendulum now is 60 centimeters. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. When the length of the pendulum is increased 4 times, the time period doubled. This indicates a square root relation between the length of the pendulum and time period of the pendulum. We will measure the time period for 2 more lengths and then try to plot a graph between the length of the pendulum and the time period of the pendulum. I have adjusted the length now to 45 centimeters. Start. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Now the length is 30 centimeters. Start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Now we will draw a graph with length on the horizontal axis and square of time period on the vertical axis. This gives a straight line, confirming a square root relation between length and time period. The exact relation between the time period T and the length L of the pendulum is given by T equal to 2 pi times square root of L by G. Here, G is the acceleration due to gravity. We had plotted T square versus L. This linearized equation has 4 pi square upon G as the slope. The value of the slope is 4.083. From this, we get the value of G, which is 9.67 meters per second square. In the next video, we will show that time period is independent of mass of the pendulum. We will also show that the time period does not depend on how big the oscillation is, that is, does not depend on the amplitude. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and share the link with your friends.